Good evening, everyone. I'm Jim Trelio, director of Westwood Winds. We started in 2010, so this is our 8th concert. And each year, I see our audience getting larger and larger. We have a few faithful groupies, I guess, you're following Westwood Winds, which is good, good. I know a lot of parents and friends and relatives of all of our members. Walk right in, we're all Westwood folks here. It's always a pleasure to, what we do is basically we're all amateur musicians, starting as young as probably the age of 14, going through retirement age. And we do this because we love music. That's all it is. Most of the younger people have been taking lessons through the Prodigy program, a program that I started here back in the 90s, and taking lessons in it, people get hooked. And unlike some sports, you know, we've been reading so much about football and concussions and brain damage. You know, unless you hit your head with your clarinet, you probably won't get a concussion, okay? And you can do this for a long, long time. So we have members here with it. You know, they're a testimony to that enthusiasm that you keep all your life. Talking about a long, long time, right? In the program, you see that we're dedicating this program to the memory of Mark Rogers. And the scripture's in there. Mark was a member of our group since it started back in 2010. I bet many of you might know Mark Rogers as the organizer and the head of the Westwood Swing Band. And that's an organization that goes back many, many, many years. And they specialize in jazz, a typical big band. And so we're remembering his participation with Westwood Winds, but also his contribution to the music in Westwood. Because the swing band probably played every morning, pancake breakfasts, and you name it, you know, and they still perform. Well, anyways, we're thinking about him. His clarinet there is his spirit is with us. Okay, tonight's theme is we're calling it an American medley. Now the word medley has all kinds of meanings, you know. But maybe, you know, you go to a restaurant and get a medley of vegetables or pasta or whatever. A medley of songs, one after another. And so certainly the word medley means something about music, but also it means about an assortment of things, assortment of people. And so I named it the American medley because America is an assortment of people. Let's face it, we're all from all around the world. You know, all of us. My parents are immigrants from Italy. Again, first generation, there are many immigrants here in this room and also generations since. So we are a medley of people, and our culture is a result of all these people. So even though you think that this is an American song, it might have been written by someone from a foreign country, or it might be about, you'll hear about the Disney song playing tonight. It's a story that came from France. So all of our culture really is, except for maybe the last 50 years or so, I should say that, because jazz, even jazz, is a mixture of influences from Africa and from kind of like Appalachia, but all the music, you know, the jigs and the bluegrass kind of music, that's been influenced by songs you're going to hear tonight, some of the piping songs and the jigs from British Isles. So, you know, none of the stuff is authentic to America, it just comes from all. Okay, starting with that, we're going to start with the Yankee fanfare. And it's Yankee Doodle. What can be more American than Yankee Doodle? Well, it's not an American. Sorry about that. It was sung by English soldiers while they were here fighting the Revolutionary War. And they were making fun of us because we didn't have uniforms. We weren't trained so well. We looked like a ragtag bunch of, you know, farmers or whatever. Our weapons were whatever we had, pitchforks and guns that might have fired, might not have fired. But we managed to win the war for a lot of reasons. And when the war was, the word Yankee Doodle, it was, the word doodle meant fool or simpleton because of the way we looked at it. But as the war changed and England was losing, we started singing that song in our own words against them. It worked. So, the power of music. You're going to hear the theme, Yankee Doodle. And it's got the spirit, America, we can do this. We're independent, we're revolutionaries. So you're going to hear that jumpy spirit. Think of the spirit of 76, that painting with the guy with the bandage. Think of the little, the flute and the drum, right? marching, that's the spirit of our America. You're going to hear that spirit, but you're going to hear the song done every which way. Different time, different melody, you're going to say melody, but different. You hear the differences.
All right, here we go. Ready? Disneyville Beach? Just a few of you? Well, I thought everybody would have gone to one of those. Currently, Beauty and the Beast is in movie theaters, and the origin of the story isn't American at all. It's a French fairy tale. And Disney had a knack of finding and using stories that would adapt well to the well-called silver screen and appeal to a wide American audience. You're going to hear Beauty and the Beast now, some of its most popular music. Enjoy. Italian. Let's hear a little bit about it. is the tarantella, which is connected to the bite of a tarantula spider. The victims were seemingly cured by dancing frenetically to the tune. I don't know if you've ever had that opportunity. I remember I married an Italian, my husband, and when we got married, I didn't really know how to dance the tarantella, so my mother-in-law had to teach me. And I'm really good at it now, so you're going to really enjoy that. The next song is Santa Lucia. That celebrates the picturesque waterfront district of Borgo Santa Lucia in the Bay of Naples. Now, I need to know, has anybody ever been there to the Bay of Naples? Santa Lucia. That's a beautiful place. And Funiculi Funicula, written to commemorate the opening of the first cable car or funicular to the top of Mount Vesuvius. Now, I'm going to ask you, anybody been to Mount Vesuvius? Wow, that's great. Did you see the funicular? Right. All right, well, enjoy this wonderful Italian medley.
Thank you.
Okay, we're coming near our intermission. And but we have another song before that. It's called Prince in Concert. We have a medley of his songs. Prince has been around for a long time. He just passed away this past April, so that's why we're commemorating him. And he comes from non-American parentage as well. And his music includes funk, rock, R&B, new wave, obviously pop. He sold over 100 million records worldwide, making him one of the best-selling artists of all time. He won an Academy Award for the film Purple Rain. He was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 2004. And we're going to perform tonight, 1999, When Doves Cry, Purple Rain. And let's go crazy.
Thank you.
crazy back here. We have an intermission, 15 minutes, to give you a chance to get some refreshments. Ice cream is being provided free tonight by the Rotary Club. And although it's free, they are requesting a donation because they do wonderful work around the world for the charitable group. So free ice cream, but give twice as much as you think it's worth. So we'll see you back here. It's 7:05, 7:20. Thank you. The next piece is called Piper's Rhapsody. And you're going to hear three songs that were played either by bagpipe or by the penny whistle. And these songs come from us from Scotland or Ireland. You're going to hear Scotland the Brave, obviously Scottish, Loch Lomond, Scottish, and the Sailor's Hornpipe. And that's kind of like pop by the Sailor kind of music, okay? Hornpipe. I mentioned that this kind of music is the stuff that English people, they live in West Virginia, bluegrass, and that influenced our American music. So, anyways, those three songs are going to be combined and played over another song from England, and that song is Amazing Grace. And that was composed by an English poet and a clergyman, John Newton. So you have Irish, Scottish, and English all mixed together.
Thank you. tip.
I feel good. Love this piece. You really rocked on this one. We're going to hear Westwood Winds rendition, a song by American singer James Brown. Anyone know James Brown?
Yeah.
He recorded this most well-known recording in 1965. The band is ready to play this funk-style 12-bar blues.
Thank you.
pushing them out of the way. That did a good job out of Louis Armstrong. What did you say? Band's last piece, Caravan. Perfect example of a mixture of international influence in the music of America. It was composed by Juan Tizzle and Duke Ellington and depicts a Middle Eastern mode of transportation by camel. You will hear this song as a samba, an energetic Latin American dance. So we're kind of combining some interesting points here. The band members really enjoy this selection. Watch how they make a smooth move and switch to percussion instruments in the middle of the song.
Thank you so much, everyone. You're a hometown audience, you're a hometown band. This is what it's all about. We're just hometown. Everyone's all together here. Before we leave, I do have some people to thank, okay? So in your programs, we thank them, but I want to ensure that you heard it, and I want to be sure that all of us know that we just don't operate in isolation because we are a part of our community. But anyways, first of all, custodians, unknown to them, it was supposed to be outdoors, it was supposed to rain, it really did rain, but anyways, like all of, we have to be in there. This is used by the recreation department during the day, during the summertime. They had to strip the tables, wash the floors, bring in 150 chairs, all that was done for us. So I want to thank all of our students. Savings Bank has been a supporter of Westwood Winds for many years. I want to be sure to give them a shout out. They are truly a community organization that supports community groups such as ours. So they have been a supporter. White Winds is a sponsor, as well as Roche Brothers sponsor. And so I'm sure that you recognize those three institutions. Fox Hill Village is a performance partner. We do a special performance just for Fox Hill Village. We performed for them last week. So we're trying to extend our reach to the community there. And so those people definitely should be recognized. I want to thank you because, as I said, there's many of you who be here who have come all the time. You don't even have relatives in there, but you evidently like what we're doing. I look forward to seeing you again next year. And I want to tell you that, I think I already mentioned this, we have the Facebook, check us on Facebook, check us on our website. Before we leave, the last group I want to thank are the members themselves. As I said, these are just ordinary people who love music, who come here, work, and commit, work hard, and I think you've heard the results of that. So congratulations. Westwood Day. So if we can get enough of you today, catch us on Saturday, September 23rd. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.